If you want to know how to use your smartphone as a webcam so you can live stream through your computer or your laptop, I want to tell you about an app that really changed the live stream game for me. Now, this is a completely unsponsored video, but it is kind of a follow-up to a video that I have on my channel. There's a video on my channel where I explain step by step the very basic live stream setup that I use to keep performing for fans and family during 2020, during the P word. The setup that I used was so basic that it didn't incorporate any outside software like OBS. But there did come a time where I felt ready to tackle OBS, and that's when I learned about the Reincubate Camo app. The Camo app is free, although there is a pro version if you want to pay for it. You do have access to things like higher resolution live streaming. You will need to download the accompanying application that's available for your laptop or desktop. It's the Reincubate Camo Studio. I have an iPhone, so everything I'm going to be doing involves a lightning cable. As you can see, I'm connecting the phone to the computer by USB. Here we go. As you can see, we've got the back camera being mirrored here on the computer. So if you've got a smartphone with a high-resolution front-facing camera, there is an option on the Computer Camo app to switch to the front-facing camera. Voila! Okay, so now the phone is connected to the computer. How is OBS going to know that we're going to be using the phone as a webcam? Here I am in OBS, and we're going to add a video capture device. I'm going to name it. And I'm going to select Reincubate Camo from the drop-down menu. We are ready to live stream. Audio is a whole different subject that I'm not really going to be getting into here. But in the other video that I've been talking about, where I talked about the basic live stream setup, what I did is I used a small multi-channel mixer and I ran everything into an iRig audio interface that went directly into the phone. Now, because the phone is directly plugged up to the computer, I'm not going to be able to use the iRig. So what I did is I ran the mixer into a very standard audio interface like the Focusrite Scarlett or a Behringer that just goes into your computer. There is a way to monitor audio levels in OBS, and I did my best at this, but it definitely was not perfect. I am not a great engineer. That is not something that I would sell my services as. So this was not perfect. Sometimes my audio did clip, even after I did a few sound checks. What I would do is I would go live, but then I would really quick go into Facebook and set the live stream to private or only me. So then later on, I could check out the audio and see where I was. So the video that's on my channel where I talked about the direct to Facebook live stream setup that I did, it went directly into the phone, into the Facebook app. That has become one of the most popular videos on my channel. It didn't start out that way. When I posted it, it was definitely, I think I would go ahead and say that it was the poorest performing video on my channel. But a few months later, I guess the algorithm picked it up and a lot of people watched it, and it turned out that it helped a lot of people. So I thought it was only right to make this follow-up video and hopefully help some people who are trying to up their live stream game even just a little bit. This is definitely still in the realm of pretty basic live streaming, but it definitely changed my live stream game, and I hope that it can change yours too. My name is Rachel. If you haven't watched any other videos on my channel, I am a musician and I do a lot of other creative things here on YouTube, so I hope that you'll consider subscribing. And I appreciate you watching this video, and good luck with your live streaming. Tell me how I keep on going.